What is up, everyone? This is Ingenious Clam, and today we're going to continue our playthrough with Final Fantasy X for the PlayStation 4. So this is the remaster version, as you could tell, as we've been playing now for a while. Last time we got some info from Luzu and Gata here, and Waka told us to go pray at the temple. So we are going to go pray at the temple, see what happens. We already got... It's been over like a week since I played this game. I am hype! So let's talk. Do you want to talk? No, she does not. Okay, I do not care. So we're gonna go inside this temple, and we are going to go pray ! At the temple. And here we see Tidus being awkward as usual. Same thing as always. So we see a woman on the ground doing the everyone is doing the quarter circle forward and punch. Everyone is doing the Hadouken.
It was then standing in that place.
Standing in that place. I was so confused because everyone was doing Hadoukens everywhere.
I began to realize how different this world was.
There's
from
a woman
home.
On the wall. There's a man on the wall. Yeah. So, Tidus is not very eloquent with words. He explained things not too well-ish. Yeah. So this here is the... a dude, obviously. This here is actually...
10 years have passed.
A father of a character we're soon to get.
And finally, we receive a statue for our temple.
Lord Broska.
What's a high summoner?
Yeah, what's a high summoner? Blasphemy!
I got too close to Sin's toxin.
Yeah. Just saying stuff, as usual, Tidus. You're being very, 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 very...
It's funny hearing myself make the same excuse
Not faring too well, exactly.
And a little sad.
He's making the same excuse over and over.
Of a sacred art.
Sworn to protect the people of Yevon. So the summoners, if you
only
could tell, and
summoners.
If you've played this game before, because it's old as, like, I don't know, like forever, and
the
you've played
Aeons
Final Fantasy before, summoners are actually people that summon monsters that fight for them.
So what he meant was that we should respect some kind of great men, or something like that, I figured.
Yeah. Nice going, Tidus. So, only sworn guardians may approach the closer trial. So I can't go in there yet. Yet. I will soon enough, though. So let's see what's here. I don't think there's anything here yet. No, there's nothing here. And let's go to the other side as well. Let's see here. Nope, nothing here. And I think there is something here in the later game, like in Final Fantasy X2. If I recall correctly, there's supposed to be a chest somewhere there, I think. So let's get out of here. And I can actually tell that I'm sounding like I have a cold. And I do have a cold, actually. But you gotta do what you gotta do, so let's go talk to Waka. I think it was in the middle one. Yeah.
Sorry, let's see. Man. No time for lunch yet. You look bushed.
Yeah, let's take a nap. Unless we do that, we can't progress the story. And fade out.
You could at least go see how they are doing.
We can't interfere. It's a rule.
It's a rule.
But it's been nearly.
And that triggers a flashback because Tidus has heard a lot of words in his life.
But it's been nearly.
It's been nearly a day already.
Perhaps you could go look for us.
People are searching for him now.
And that right there in the background, the woman is Tidus's mom. Tidus's mom.
Who cares whether he
And that there is a baby Tidus.
But he might die.
He looks like a brat.
Hate him so?
Yep.
But if he dies, You'll never be able to tell him how much you hate him.
She has a point. So that's a flashback. Again, there's gonna be a lot of them. If you have warp, and nap time's over. No Waka anywhere, and no food Waka? Anywhere. Waka, give me my food, man! What you gotta do to get some food? This, oh my god. I've been hungry since like the first episode. Give me some food! And Waka went in here. And now we are going to follow him. So many people doing the Hadouken.
Something wrong?
Something wrong?
Someone hasn't returned from the trial.
Eh?
Eh?
Well, apprentice summoner, really.
Huh?
There's a room in there called the Cloister
of Trials. He's making such weird noises. He's like a monkey.
If the prayer is heard, the apprentice.
Well, actually, there's a cutscene later in the game that confirms that
remember?
He. Oh, sorry about that. I actually didn't touch the mic.
There's
a cutscene later in the game that confirms that he is actually a monkey.
A day's already gone by.
Is it particularly dangerous in there?
No, it's not dangerous
sometimes
in there. Waka,
don't go in and help.
Don't.
There's already guardians in there. Besides, it's forbidden.
Waka's
hey,
being such a douche.
What if
sometimes,
the
yes.
Dies?
No, it's not dangerous in there.
The precepts must be obeyed.
Like I care.
Like I care.
So, Tidus is ignoring all the teachings of this world, and he's ignoring all of the rules and the taboos
maybe
and stuff like that.
This wasn't such a good idea after
yeah,
all.
Yeah, now you've figured that out. The Cloister Trials. Those who seek to learn of Yevon's secret arts are tested by the Cloister Trials. Find the right way and you will be taken to the Chamber of Faith. Examine the objects with blah 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 blah. Yeah, so let's examine this. No, okay, let's examine this first. Strange glyph appears. Arrows! And we do not get an option to not touch the glyph here. We need to touch this glyph to make that appear. And now we're going to go to this glyph and touch that glyph. So basically what this is, the Cloister Trials, it's a puzzle. And in this puzzle there is a treasure. There is one treasure. Well, at least in this puzzle. So yeah. They explain some sort of stuff here. Glyph spheres open the way to the Chamber of Faith. Yeah, that's we need the glyph spheres to proceed. Destruction spheres open the way to hidden treasure. And that is the sphere that we need to get the hidden treasure. Because we need the hidden treasure. It seems that Besaid spheres are also necessary. Yeah, the Besaid spheres, it's called Besaid spheres because we're in Besaid, and it would be called Kilika spheres once we're in Kilika. So, I can only carry one sphere at a time, because why not? So, the Besaid spheres, or the location spheres, actually, they trigger various effects. Glyph spheres open doors and stuff like that. Let's see, I'll take it once more. And we are going to put it right here. There we go. And this is the destruction sphere, yeah. So we're not gonna bother with that yet. We're gonna touch these symbols. yeah, touch the glyph, and a door opens. And here we see blue stuff. And that is that Besaid sphere. We're gonna take that sphere. And the blue stuff disappears. We are going to, let's see, there's nothing here yet, right? Yeah, there's nothing there. Let's insert the Besaid Sphere right here. As I said, the Besaid Sphere triggers various effects. There we go. It made a wall disappear. I'm not doing this, so yeah, it's automatic. Move the pedestal set with the sphere to the correct place. We can step on the shining glyph to make it go back. And we're not going to do that yet, because as you recall, we had a destruction sphere to take care of. We'll take that destruction sphere. And we're gonna run over here, and we're gonna put it right here. And then one thin line should appear. There we go. Over there. And the wall goes boom. And that is the treasure. And when we open this treasure, there will be another glyph appearing. That glyph. And that glyph, or that symbol, is the symbol of another summon monster that we cannot obtain unless we find every single treasure for every single cloister of trial. Little destructions here. Destruction treasure. So let's move this right here forward. This is not hard at all. You just have to move it straight ahead like that.
Hey!
Hey!
What's gotten into you? Hey, it's okay. Only summoners, apprentice summoners, and their guardians can enter here.
Yep.
It's a tradition. Very important.
It's a tradition. Very important.
So what about you?
Yeah, what about him?
I'm a guardian.
What did you expect, Titus?
A guardian?
Stop being such an ass. So, an elevator appears. A Wakai's not phased at all.
To pray at every temple in Spira. Guardians protect them.
As their name would suggest.
The guardian's in there now. One of them's got a sure fuse. And who knows what the other's thinking.
He's probably not thinking.
Well, now that we come this far, might as well go all the way.
Might as well go all the way. So yeah, this would be awkward.
What are you doing here? Didn't think we'd be able to handle it.
No, it's, it's just...
trying to reach for stuff. Oh my god.
See, I told you she gets mad easy.
She gets mad easy. This here is... well, for the beginning of the game, this is bitch number one.
Is the summoner all right?
Who are you?
I'm Titus. I'm an ass. So yeah, that girl is bitch number one. She's not very nice in the beginning of the game. She gets nicer later in the game. If I recall correctly. My voice cracked. Oh my god. So here we have the amazing graphics of Final Fantasy X. These graphics are actually amazing. At least for a 2001 game, I think. And she's a little bit lightheaded, and she is going to fall over. Good thing the blue dude is very, very quick. Waka looks fat. And Titus looks like an ass. And she's sweaty.
I've done it. I have become a summoner.
Yay! I have become a summoner. Yay! She also knows the Hadouken, apparently. Everyone knows the Hadouken.
Man, was I surprised.
Yeah, you should be.
Here I was thinking summoners were all old geezers.
Yeah, all old geezers. So we're going to talk with this dude, and he is going to put my transgression on the side for now. Yay! So even if you do taboo stuff, as long as it ends happily ever after, you can do taboo stuff. Whoop, whoop. I want to talk to the... ugh, never mind.
What?
And he's got me in a chokehold.
Wait till you see this.
And he just pushes people away.
I can't see anything.
Ready.
Ready. So here we are going to see her first, like, summon. And I think this first summon actually made his debut in this game. Because, well, I can't remember, actually. I've played all other Final Fantasies before this one. And I can't actually recall ever seeing this one in those 1-9. So lights up in the sky, and down goes this dude. Or girl, actually. I think it's a girl. It's rather majestic, actually. So, let's pet it. Let's pet the big bird. Pet the horn. And the feathers. It is actually kind of cool. It is actually one of my favorite summons in the game. I like it. I like the design. It's not super strong.
I've never seen anything like it in my
life.
It's
really strong now in the beginning, but it's not like super, super strong.
But still, I could feel a strange kind of gentleness coming from it.
Yeah, well, I don't think it's gonna kill you, Titus. Unless you're on the wrong side. So this summon's name is Valifor. Or Valifor. I've always gone with Valifor. Actually, a funny thing. Back in the day when a friend of mine actually got this game before me, he was called up to dinner, and I was left down in his room. On this, right on this particular screen, and I thought I would mess with him and actually do like that. I don't know why that is messing with people. I just felt like I was messing with him by putting the S there instead of the R. And when he came back down, he's like, "Is that right? Was his name really Valifos?" I'm like, "Right." But yeah, we're gonna name it Valifor because this is Valifor.
I remember.
You remember?
Night, we talked for the first time. I didn't know it then, but after that night,
everything changed.
For everyone.
For me. Yes. So the night after, and we're standing in the same place.
This guy here wants into the tournament so bad, I let him on the team.
Yeah, right. You forced me, you douche.
His memory's a little fuzzy, so don't mind him if he says anything odd.
Yeah, like
on,
you guys
hi.
Aren't odd. He's telling me that don't mind me if I say something odd, and you guys are the oddest one of them all.
Hi, guys.
He's wearing...
So what's our goal?
Bada is wearing, like, checkered pants? Yes! What, he didn't have straight blue ones?
Our new goal is victory!
Or maybe he is more fabulous than the other ones.
To bring the Crystal Cup back to our island. That's all we need to do to win.
Well,
easy, huh?
The Crystal Cup would be hard to bring back to the island. We could bring back the Crystal Cup trophy, but the Crystal Cup itself is probably going to be held at Luka. Since, you know, they have the arena. Jesus, Walker.
Victory!
Victory!
Yeah!
Yep, we're going for victory, dudes. And I am actually going to win, so... Let's talk to Keep Up. Hit the other team Han and make it easy on the goalkeeper, yeah? Of course we're going to do it. Everyone's acting like well, everyone. And Bada says victory, huh? Dato says, hey, I was hoping you'd join the team all along, yeah? Of course. There's going to be 6 teams from all of the Spirit at the tournament. Yeah, there's going to be... Let's see, B-Sade Aurochs, Luka Goers, Killika Beasts, Ronzo Fangs, Guadu Glories, and Albed Sykes. Those are the 6 teams, and we're gonna approach
you
now.
Heathen!
Heathen!
Stay away from the summoner!
You're
a bad man!
No, I'm not.
Lady Yuna,
I'm just
be
an idiot.
Careful.
But it was really my fault to begin with.
Oh. Yeah, it was. So this is Yuna.
I'm Yuna.
This is our
Thank
love
you so
interest
much for
the game.
Help earlier.
Huh? I'm sorry about that.
And she is... I think she's the same age as Titus. I think she's 17.
Guess I kind of overreacted.
Yeah, you did.
Oh, no. I was overconfident.
Well, you stop apologizing, both of you.
I saw that Aeon thing. That's amazing.
Yeah, it is kind of amazing.
Do you think I can become High Summoner?
And he's nodding, and she gets happy, and I don't know why she gets happy, because it's not a really good idea to become a High Summoner. And little girl wants to play.
So, tomorrow then.
Tomorrow?
I can't actually think of another game that the voice actor of Yuna have actually been, like, voicing. I think it's Hedy Barres, or something like that. I know that the guy who does Titus, I think it's James Arnold Taylor, I think it is. I know that guy is the voice actor for Ratchet in the Ratchet & Clank games. And we are actually going to reject her so hard, she's not my type.
Then we're cool.
Then we're cool.
Hey, but what if she, like, comes on to me?
That's not going to happen, bro.
That's not going to happen. If you get tired, let me know. I had a bed made for you.
Coolio. So if we approach you more now, they'll just say the same thing.
Stay away from the summoner!
Stay away from the summoner! So I don't think there's much else to do here. Yeah, no, we can't. Yeah, we're gonna talk with Waka. Because we're gonna go to bed.
Sleep tight.
So yeah, I don't know if Hedy Beres has done something else. I think I'm gonna have to research this after I'm done with this. And I know that James Arnold Taylor did the voice for Ratchet in Ratchet & Clank. He's actually the only... I think he's the only guy that has voiced Ratchet & Clank. That's kind of cool. Yeah, this is not a dream. Of course it's not. Can we go back? Hey, we can go back, but we get sent right back here. So let's go to the left. When in doubt, go left.
Where's that boat?
Everyone will find us if it doesn't come soon.
Yep.
You really sure this is okay?
Would you take me to Zanarkand?
Zanarkand.
Hey!
Yeah, because that's a great idea.
You said you'd go with me!
He's got several girls!
I thought Waka told you not to get any ideas.
He did?
Yeah, so you're coming with me.
Yep.
Hey, stop dreaming!
Stop dreaming!
You with a woman? You can't even catch a ball!
Like, you can catch these balls.
Oh, what's the matter?
Yeah, the thing is... when Titus is dreaming or when he's remembering Jack, his dad... His dad isn't this mean,
huh?
Actually.
You
it's kind of funny.
Gladly.
Because Titus remembers him as this fucking douche that just tells his son that you're not good enough, I'm so much better than you. But of course he's better than him, he's an adult. And Titus misinterprets this as he's like putting him down. And someone's dead.
He does look a lot like Chuck.
Graphics!
I was surprised too.
Yay! Waka looks so fat.
But no matter what he looks like, he isn't Chapu.
Oof!
You shouldn't have brought him here in the first place.
Yeah, but he needed our help.
He did need our help.
Excuses again?
Lulu is actually really good looking.
That's it. No more. Enough, Waka.
Enough, Waka. And he did very, very badly right there. Yeah, of course he did. Because Waka is this awkward, awkward character in this game. Nothing ever goes his way.
Scary.
Scary.
So, who's Chapu?
My little brother.
Chapu.
Looked like you.
Two consonants right there. Chapu, Waka, Datu.
He was with the Crusaders when they
Jasu. Everyone has got these. Except Lulu and Yuna. Well, technically she does have two consonants and two vowels, but...
Oh, so that's why.
I became a guardian to fight sin, yeah?
Revenge?
Fight sin, yeah? Revenge.
That was the idea. I'm more worried about a stupid game now than avenging my brother.
Avenging my brother?
After the next tournament, I'll be a guardian full time. I know it kind of looks like I'm using you.
But I'm not. Yeah, you are.
Don't worry. I mean, I owe you a lot. You really helped me out, you know?
You know?
What I mean is... Thanks, Waka.
Thanks, Waka.
Stop. You're embarrassing me.
Yeah. I like Waka. I know many people don't like Waka. I actually like Waka. He's a cool dude. So So this is actually the same place as we started in this episode, but in a different angle. We're not going to say we're going to just heal up, and we actually we do have Waka with us. Cool. A hover out. And here we go. Waka's holding something.
Hey, sleepyhead. Something I want to give you.
Whoa, you're giving this? To me?
So now we get Titus's trademark weapon for the game.
That's the sword you gave Chapu.
Well, he never used it. Where's Yuna?
We're taking the same boat as Yuna, right? Why do we gotta wait here?
Because we'll leave as a team.
Yuna came to this village 10 years ago when the last calm started.
The calm?
Yep.
Since then, she's been like a little sister to me and Lulu.
She has, actually.
She had the talent. She became an apprentice. Now, today, she leaves as a summoner.
This is our journey. We should leave together.
Exactly. We leave as a team. And with a giant freaking bag.
You really don't need all that luggage. They're not
really
my
girl things. With 50 belts.
They're gifts for the temples we're to visit.
This isn't a vacation, Yuna.
I guess you're right.
The thing is, that bag is actually coming with us anyway.
Okay, off we go.
And she doesn't Hadouken. So there has been a lot of running around, a lot of cutscenes, but now, finally, we are actually going to fight! Yay!
Here comes one now.
That's a dingo.
Why don't you try out that sword I gave you?
We can kill that in one shot. Swing!
No problem.
Not too shabby. You kept up with him pretty well. Might make a good guardian someday.
Yeah. And this is
a
condor, I think. Yeah, condor. And boom! So Titus is nimble, and he can hit the nimble grounded foes, like lizards and dingoes and dogs and stuff like that. He's good against those foes. Waka, however, is better against flying enemies because flying enemies have much higher evasion. And here we go. We gave him agility +2, so he's a little bit faster. And we're actually going to learn some more right up here, up the hill. And like right about now, I think. It's anytime now. There we go.
Looks like trouble.
It does look like trouble.
Watch this!
Yeah, this is... Can I... Nope, okay. You're going to embarrass yourself. Whoop.
Told ya. Only magic can beat that thing.
Because that is a flan, a water flan, to be specific.
Like. Magic? Element?
Let's have our black mage
show you what I mean.
Lou, you're up.
Lou!
Clueless, aren't you? Good thing I'm here.
So yeah, elements. There's fire, ice, lightning, and water. Fire and ice are opposed, as are lightning and water.
Spells of ice work well against fire fiends.
And fire works well against ice.
Against fire magic. You follow?
I get fire and ice, but what about lightning and water?
What do you think?
Lightning and water are opposed.
Oh my god, Titus.
This one here is a water fiend, which means...
I don't know. I'm going to use fire water on it. No, we're not going to use... We're going to use thunder. Oh my god, Titus. You're such an ass. So Lulu is very, very good against elemental type enemies like flans and the... elementals, I guess. And Waka is good against the nimble flyers. Titus is good against the nimble grounded foes. And Yuna is just freaking badass because she has a freaking summon monster. And I actually like how the summoning works in this game. Back in like Final Fantasy 9 and 8 and 7 and stuff like that, the summons were just like monster, like an extra magic, you know? You did the summon and it came onto the screen and it did a little dance, and did a little damage. And that's it. But here, you actually get to fight with the summon monster. So you summon the monster, and it has its own HP. It has his own MP, its own attacks, and stuff like that. It's actually really interesting. Its own overdrives as well. And the overdrives are freaking nuts.
What's
at least in the beginning
on?
Of the game. What's going on? So, Waka is praying.
It's an ancient custom.
People leaving the island pray here for a safe trip.
Chapu didn't pray that day.
Said he meets his boat. So, they are all praying. And I'm just gonna watch.
That should do it.
Yep. That should do it, actually. Yeah, I know I'm being a douche, but... yeah, I'm being a douche. Yay! So, here is actually our... I think it's our second or third boss? Fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth. Right when we pass in here. It's the blue dude! Roar! Roar! Boom! Boom! At first, when I played this game the first time, I thought he went nuts. So we're gonna attack him. He's gonna attack me. I'm gonna attack him. He's gonna attack me. I'm gonna attack him. And he's gonna jump. This is gonna hurt. I think I can do like one more. There we go. I'm actually gonna cheer up. There's no way he can kill me anyways. And I actually want him to jump at me. Ow! And we're gonna use a potion. I'm doing this. I'm being being really stupid right now because I want another overdrive. what's it called? Overdrive mode. There's something called a daredevil, and the daredevil is pretty good. And the jump attack really hurts. Stop jumping! Ow! And actually, I'm actually doing this because I want to overkill him. And overkill, if. I don't think I've done an overkill yet, but overkill is when you do a set amount of damage to them while killing them. And it gives you more AP, it gives you double the items, I think. And I think... yeah, I think that's it. I'm just gonna keep cheering up. Cheering up... cheer is just actually stacked by fire, I think I mentioned this in earlier episodes. Stop dodging, I want to get hit! But I'm just gonna keep cheering until I get my overdrive. Cheer, cheer, cheer. Yay. Jump. That can't miss, actually, because that's his overdrive. I'm gonna potion up. Yay. Cheer. Can we just get my overdrive now, please? Thank you. So now we're gonna use Spiral Cut. There we go. And this is going to do max damage. Hopefully this will overkill. There we go. 770. Overkill, double AP, double items.
That's enough.
If it's not a weapon. Weapon is not doubled. And he's just... no. Nope.
What's with that guy?
He's strong?
Kimari Ronso. Of the Ronso tribe. He's learned the
fiend's way of fighting.
That's not what I meant.
He's another Yuna's guardians.
Yeah, he is.
Huh?
So, what they mean with him, he doesn't talk much.
Talk
yeah,
much anyway.
He's not a talkative kind of guy. But the thing is, the fiend's way of fighting means that he's the blue mage of the game.
Hmm.
And if you don't know what a blue mage is, the blue mage... oh, that was a lot of AP. I got a metal bangle! Yay! And four ability spheres. That will actually come in handy. Let's see. Metal Bangle. That's for Lulu. Defense plus 5. There we go. So yeah, blue magic is sort of... well, it is the enemy skills, actually. Basically, it's enemy skills. In Final Fantasy VII, it's called enemy magic, I think. No, it's enemy skill material. It's the enemy skill. Final Fantasy VIII, it's blue magic. Well, it is... Keystis,
Flyer!
That's your department,
let's
right?
see. Keys this limit break.
Why don't we let our summoner show us what she's made of?
Yeah, let's have the summoner. So let's switch out Tidus and switch in Yuna.
Your first real battle. Let's see some style.
Let's see
show
some style.
Us what your training has taught you, Yuna.
Okay.
Yep. So, summoning Aeos. Summon Balafor. I'm actually going to set this to short after this first one, because I don't feel like watching the full animations every single time. But yeah, as I was saying, Keystis from Final Fantasy VIII, it's her limit break as well. It's called Blue Magic. Final Fantasy IX, I think it's Quina. Quina has the Blue Magic ability. Sonic Wings, it affects the, as you can see, the turn order. I can attack twice after it, so I'm going to do that once. It doesn't do a lot of damage, though. Don't know why I did that. Dodging! And Valifor actually has the four basic elements of magic as well. That's not too bad. We can... Well, listen to me! Thunder! Thunder! Boom! Sonic Boom! Ow. I think that usually has a delay effect, but since Aeons are immune to that thing, it doesn't affect me. Sonic Boom! Regular attack! Ow! Regular attack! Let's see if I can get the overdrive. I did get the overdrive. Sonic Boom! There we go. So, when doing overdrives, it takes up a lot of time, so... Doing overdrives with Aeons when there's one enemy with a lot of health is a really, really terrible idea. I only do it when I know it's gonna kill. So, this is gonna kill. And I think it would kill him from full health as well. Energy Ray! And when I first saw this, I'm like, holy crap, that's the attack for Final Fantasy VIII! Final Fantasy VIII was the first Final Fantasy game I played, and there's a spider bot in the beginning of the game that has the exact attack. So we're gonna switch out Yuna, because I'm not gonna use Yuna at the moment. Lulu got a variable Mog. And that's the Brotherhood. It is automatically equipped, strength plus 5%. Waka has nothing else, and I actually prefer having Waka up there. There we go. Actually, I prefer like that. There we go. So let's run over here. And there's a fight. Fight, fight, and there's a big one. That's a big one. Oh, yes, yeah, this is another tutorial.
No problem. Leave this
one to me, yeah? Say goodnight, birdie. I've never played this game before. Dark attack. Inflicts dark for 3 turns for 5 MP. It's not 100% guaranteed, but it's a really good ability anyways. Then Waka gets to see the Buster attacks later as well. Let's see. Let's just attack. So, at first he gets the attacks. The dark attack, silence attack, sleep attack, and zombie attack, I think. And then later he gets the busters, like the dark buster, silence buster. And those are 100% guaranteed, but they will only last for one turn. So these attacks, dark attack, it will last for 3 turns, but it's not 100% guaranteed. So there, it wore off. Blizzard! Well, let's attack. Swing! And it's dead. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Enchanted Rod. I actually got the Rod of Wisdom as well. So that's the treasure we got from the temple. It's a really, really good item for a staff for Yuna now in the beginning of the game. So we're going to let her have that one. And we're actually going to get another armor for her that's really, really good. Oh, let's run over here. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. So this is one for each of us. Tidus is good against these ones. Waka is good against that one. And Lulu completely rapes that one. Thunder! Good way to learn. Level up! We're not going to do that right now. We're going to do that a little later. A little later. So we're going to go down here. Remember this? This is where we were in the last episode. Waka pushed us down, down a cliff that way. Because he's an ass. You know, actually, I'm going to go back. I'm going to go up here. I'm going to fight a little. A little bit, at least. We're going to get some more AP experience, whatever you want to call it, at the moment, because we need it. Ambushed! Fudge! Fudgesicle. Yeah, that is Lulu's primary stat. One of them, at least. Down, down, down.
Take that.
Boom!
Piece of cake!
Piece of cake! So yeah, I'm actually gonna gain one more level with Titus, I figured. So yeah, Lulu's primary stat is magic and magic defense, but her evasion is off the charts if you compare it with Waka and Titus. Oh my god, look at that evasion! Well, the evasion doesn't matter much later in the game when you actually raise the luck, so. But yeah. Lulu's primary stats are magic defense, and evasion. So she can evade physical attacks and she can take magic hits. Which is kind of good. Boom. We're gonna guard. And we're gonna thunder it up.
Need a good jolt?
Need a little jolt. And she has. That's actually kind of fun. They have these quotes they do when they're using the magic for the first time. Lulu has one for every black magic. I think Waka has one for every attack, like the dark attacks. And I think he has for drain and osmosis as well. Titus has for like the haste and slow magics. Yuna has for the white magics. Titus can't hit that for shit. But we're gonna try anyway. Oop, nope, not item, not item. Thunder! Da, 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 da. The victory fanfare is still the same after all these years. Which is kind of good, kind of good. I think three more fights will actually be enough. Preemptive strike, yay! Kill that. Can we crit once to get an overkill, please? I need overkills. I need the AP.
Woohoo!
Woohoo! 4. Oh my god, let's go, let's go. I wish I had the, I actually don't remember if it's actually in this game. I know there's a charm bangle that lowers the encounter rate. I don't know if there's something that actually raises the encounter rate. Yay, overkill! That gives me a whole, 2 more, I think, so 6, yeah. There we go. No, we're not gonna go back, we're gonna go this way. Yes, we're gonna learn flee! So now we can flee without, flee without fail. Me pressing buttons. And we're gonna get agility plus 1. Waka is going to get 200 more HP. And Lulu, what the hell was that? Lulu is going, not going upwards. She's gonna get 20 more MP. Yeah, there we go. And that will be it for Besaid Island. So let's go this way and go down. And yeah, I'm actually gonna end it right here for the moment. I might pick up the stream again a little later on. But this will be it for this part. Like, share, comment, and subscribe. I am the Ingenious Clam, and I am out.